So good morning. What was the last topic we discussed? We were discussing regarding the, yes, Himanshu? Plantation agriculture, commercial farming, plantation agriculture. Thank you. So plantation agriculture, that form of agriculture which generally occur on an extensive areas where the single crop produced with the modern techniques of farming. Such kind of agriculture practices are generally for the commercial to gain maximum profits, to increase the margin of profits. For this, plantation agriculture is generally occur. So plantations has an interface of agriculture and industries. So it is basically occurred in an areas of agro-based industries where agro-based industries are situated and supportive services like storage centers, nearness of markets. So what conditions are basically influence the growth of plantation agriculture? Storage facilities. Second, nearness of markets. Third, well developed land and waterways, because plantation agriculture products are basically used for exports, which are generally used for the exports. They are generally used for exports. And exports in our Indian economy has increasing after the independence because of improving the agriculture practices. Second type of commercial farming, mixed farming is also known as intercropping, in which two or more than two crops, they are collectively produced in a same agricultural season. This is as a modern form of, haan ji, multiple bhi kehte hain, intercropping bhi kehte hain, in which as with the production of plants, there is also as a rearing of animals. It also includes as a rearing of animals. Two or more than two crops, but in present, maximum portions of Indian agricultural fields, farmers rearing animals, they are practicing the dairy farming with support of agriculture. Why? Because agriculture generates income once or twice in a year after the harvesting of crops, and the dairy farming helps to regularize income through which farmers and their dependence for credit on moneylenders reduce in present. Moneylenders consider as informal sources of credit, which are charging as a high interest rate and without documentation or securities guarantees, they are lending the money to their borrowers. But as compared to them, the banks, they are charging as a securities for the repayment of their loans. But farmers, they are not preferred to go towards the banks because their procedure is lengthy. borrowing the loans from the banks, their procedure is a lengthy and a time consuming. When a farmers require money on the spot or a short period of time, they prefer to go towards the money lenders. जिसको आरतिया कहते हैं, ठीक है? Which are lending a money, certain amount of money, but they are charging as a high interest rate, but without any guarantees. Clear? Without any guarantees. Is that clear? This was as a commercial farming. Any doubts till there? Subsistence farming, the three of the parts: primitive subsistence farming, slash and burn agriculture, and third, intensive subsistence farming. Intensive subsistence farming. Then afterwards, the next as a commercial farming, which includes as a plantation agriculture and mixed farming. So any of the questions? कोई copy दे दो sphere. Any other question? Next are the cropping patterns. Cropping patterns. Cropping patterns. As per the existing geographical, climatic, social and cultural conditions, social and cultural conditions, as per existing geographical, climatic, social and cultural conditions, which influence production of crops, which influence production of crops, production of crops, which is vary from state to state, three different crops are possible to produce in Ganga Brahmaputra plains as compared to this. Three crops of rice, same kind of a crops, three crops of rice are possible to produce in Assam. In Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, we can produce as a three crops, three separate crops in a three agriculture season, Kharif, Rabi, Zaid. But in Assam, we can produce as a three crops of rice from a same category of a food crop. We can produce a three rice crops in a year, Zayad is a short tenure season which has lies in between of Kharif and Rabi. Rabi and Kharif. Winter or summer ke beech mein there is as a short tenure of a 45 to 60 days of a time period in which especially as a pulses are produced by the farmers. Pulses. Watermelon इसमें आता है, ठीक है? Any other? चलें आगे. क्या बोला? Crops in a year. First, kharif, kharif. Kharif season, it begins with onset of monsoons. So Rahul, which month is considered as the onset of the monsoons, advancing monsoon season? It began in India through which month? Louder. Kya kaha na? July. Sure. The estimated time, yes. Prabgun, she asked some of the question related with it. So first week of June has considered as the time, as estimated time when the monsoon striking on the coast of Kerala. So July keh rahe hain Rahul aap, it is a time when the monsoons approaching towards the northwestern parts of country, Punjab, Rajasthan, Delhi. Okay, so onset of monsoons in June. Onset of monsoons in June to September, June to September, June to September. In some areas, it has extended till October also. It depends upon a type of a crop, type of a paddy crop, which is sowing at the month of June or either July. For example, in a Punjab, government of a Punjab has restricted the farmers not to produce, not to sow the crop of a paddy earlier than the 10th June. Reason, because of high evaporation. Evaporation high hota hai, high temperature ki wajah, that's why government restricted the sowing of paddy crop. Uske baad isliye ki because of monsoons day starts. So in a intervals of monsoons they begin as per the normal in condition. This year monsoons are not normal in condition. Yes, Prabhu, that was your question. Around 2 months earlier, you read the news. Okay. So kharif, which begins with the onset of the monsoons in June towards September, towards September, as a meteorology is what? It's a science of a study to climate, study climate, meteorology. So as per the meteorology, it's rainy season in which paddy means rice, paddy, maize, jowar, groundnut, moong, cotton, jute and soya bean are generally produced in all over the country some of the areas in India which are known for more than two crops of rice in a given period of time, these are Assam, Meghalaya, and West Bengal. Assam, Meghalaya, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha. Why is this possible that we can produce two or more than two crops in such states? Yes, you. Your name? Answer. Why do we call that in Assam, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, these are such of the areas where we can produce two or more than two crops of rice in a year? Rain, very good. Regular supply of water. Supply, enough percentage of water is available in such areas. But as compared to this, the water availability, there is a scarcity of water in Punjab. As you read in previous classes, rice required as more than 80 to 100 centimeters annual rainfall. But in Punjab, 70 to 80 centimeters annual rainfall records. Because of this, we can't produce as paddy in Punjab. But still, paddy is possible to produce through the third girl. Paddy is possible to produce in Punjab because of irrigation, assured irrigation facilities. Through the canals and tube wells, paddy is possible to produce in Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. Clear, Dhavnesh? Next. Next, Rabi season, R-A-B-I, Rabi season. Rabi crop is generally sowing in October to April. April time of Baisakhi, harvesting of wheat, October to April. So in some parts, it has extends till the mid of the June also. It depends upon the sowing. If the that kind of a wheat we sowing on a month of a December or either November. So such crop, it will be as harvest on May or June. Aisa kyun hota hai? Because of such areas where the sugarcane has produced by the farmers. Sugarcane is an annual crop, which is generally sowing at the month of January and February, harvest in a month of December and January. December and January. So such agriculture fields where earlier in a previous year as a sugarcane produced, in such areas, lateral wheat production is occur. Lateral wheat production and that kind of a wheat, it will be harvested in the mid of the June. Okay? Kuch areas hain. But in a major portion, the wheat, it is generally sowing at the month of October, November and harvest in April. Important crops, which includes under it as the wheat, barley, gram, mustard, peas, P-E-A-S, which are generally producing in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, because all these areas experiencing the winters. Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, etc. During this Rabi season, rain occur in northern and northwestern states of India. It supports the growth of rabi crops. What we call such kind of a rainfall, Taneja? Diksha Taneja? Yes. What we call to a that kind of a rain, which generally occur in a month of a January in Punjab, Haryana, Delhi, Himachal. Next to Prabhgun. Yes. No. Yes, you? Wheat. Rain is called a wheat. Repeat. What we call to that kind of a rain which occur in a month of a January in northern parts of India. Punjab, Haryana, J&K, Himachal, Delhi. Yes, Dhavnesh. Main Punjab ki baat kar raha hun. I'm here talking about a Punjab, not for the West Bengal, because West Bengal is not known for the wheat production. High pressure kahin par bhi ho, what we call to a such winds which are cause a rainfall, it is very productive for the growth of a wheat plant. Advancing monsoon season begins in a June July. Retreating monsoon season extends in a September October. Iske ilawa, yes, you read the climate chapter last year, you are living in a Punjab, sorry, विंटर रेनफॉल, उसे विंटर रेनफॉल कहते हैं, जो समर में होती है वो समर रेनफॉल होगी। आप पंजाब में रह रहे हो या साउथ वेस्ट वाओ, साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून, मैं कह रहा हूं मॉनसून्स, दे आर एडवांसिंग मॉनसून सीजन इज एक्सटेंड फ्रॉम जून टू जुलाई, जून जुलाई अगस्त, सेप्टेंबर अक्टूबर इज अ टाइम ऑफ रिट्रीटिंग मॉनसून विंड्स। सो अर्लियर दोज विंड्स विच आर मूविंग फ्रॉम अ साउथ वेस्ट, दे बिकम्स एज अ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्लीज, retreating monsoon winds. Mera question hai, what we call to such winds which are causing the rain in our northern parts of India. Haan ji, thoda jor se bolo. Orographic is a type of a rainfall which cause due to the mountainous structures. When a mountain comes on a path of winds. Yes, who will answer? Second last girl. Next. Yes, Aditi. Yes, you. Anybody else? Yes, you. Nobody? Yes, Rahul. Rahul is ready to answer. North? Northeast. Northeast what? It's a direction or a type of a rain. Winds. Northeast winds. Northeast winds. Northeast winds. Near thing. उन्होंने कहा हाई प्रेशर डेवलप होता है. कहां होता है आप ये बता दो. बे ऑफ बंगाल पे हाई प्रेशर होता है. और लो प्रेशर पंजाब में. सो विंड्स की मूवमेंट साउथ वेस्ट टुवर्ड्स और नॉर्थ वेस्ट स्टार्ट हो जाती है. साउथ वेस्ट एंड नॉर्थ वेस्ट. आप कह रहे हैं पहले जो मानसून साउथ वेस्ट थे फिर वो नॉर्थ ईस्ट हुए उसके बाद साउथ वेस्ट टू नॉर्थ वेस्ट चलेगा. ये क्या था आप यही कह रहे हैं. वेस्ट बंगाल इन मैं वही कह रहा हूं पहले जो विंड साउथ से नॉर्थ गई फिर नॉर्थ से साउथ गई फिर वो वेस्ट से. ये क्या हो रहा है. फॉर ईस्ट से साउथ ईस्ट से नॉर्थ वेस्ट की ओर चली गई. क्रिस क्रॉस पैटर्न बन गया. वेरी गुड वेरी गुड. उससे मिल गया. मेडिटेरेनियन सच विंड्स आर ओरिजिनेट इन अ मेडिटेरेनियन सी बट इट इज नॉट अ टाइप ऑफ अ रेनफॉल. द टाइप ऑफ अ रेनफॉल इज अ वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस विच आर कॉज पश्चिमी विक्षोभ कहा जाता है इसको. Which generally cause a rainfall in a month of January after Maghi. Lohri ke baad aati hai. Lohri tak sleet bahut zyada padta hai, frost padta hai. Because of a frost and a sleet, crop production it reduced. Because of growth of a plant, it affected due to the sleet. Kohra jab padta hai. Jab rain start hoti hai, tab temperature starts to increase. It is productive, it is helpful for the growth of a wheat plant. वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस. आप कहीं और ही ले गए हमें. ये पढ़ा हुआ है ना लास्ट ईयर. आप कहते नहीं पढ़ा हुआ. बहुत कुछ पढ़ा हुआ है इसी चैप्टर से रिलेटेड है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अनदर थिंग व्हाट इज द क्विक टाइम पीरियड ऑफ अ रिपनिंग ऑफ मैंगोज. दीक्षा मैंगोज जो थ्रू आउट द ईयर अवेलेबल हैं, जनवरी में आ जाते हैं दिसंबर में आ जाते हैं उसका नेचुरल रेडी होने का रिपनिंग टाइम पीरियड इज व्हाट. तनीजा आंसर. मार्च में मैंगोस आ जाते हैं मार्केट में. वो 150 रुपीस मिलते हैं. मींस वो ऑफ सीजन आ रहा है. अगर वो इन सीजन होगा उसकी प्राइसेस डाउन होगी बिकॉज इन सीजन में सप्लाई ज्यादा हो जाती है. सप्लाई इफेक्ट मैंने आपको पहले कहा सप्लाई डिमांड के साथ काम करती है. फिर सोचो 150 रुपीस में है तो यानी उसकी शॉर्टेज है. अभी वो ऑफ सीजन आ रहा है. मई में आते हैं. सेम मार्केट में जाओ कभी वेजिटेबल मार्केट जुलाई में आते हैं. टाइम पीरियड ऑफ अ रिपनिंग ऑफ मैंगोस इज एज द जुलाई. आपने मैंगो शावर्स पढ़े होंगे लास्ट ईयर. आप कह रहे नहीं पढ़े. पढ़े हैं तो भी आंसर नहीं दिया. स्ट्रेंज है कोरिलेशन चैप्टर के साथ पढ़ा हुआ है आपने. तो एमसीक्यू उसमें ऐसे ही सीधे क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे. तो आज टेस्ट है. ऑल हैव टू अपीयर फॉर इट. वेरी इजी टेस्ट. रियली वेरी इजी टेस्टिंग. इट विल बी ओपन ओनली फॉर द 30 मिनट्स. उसके बाद बंद कर दिया जाएगा. सो लेट्स बी कंटिन्यू. रबी क्रॉप्स वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस विच आर ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द मेडिटेरेनियन सी. और जो हाई प्रेशर आपने कहा वेस्ट बंगाल में होता है. हाई प्रेशर डेवलपिंग ऑन अ मेडिटेरेनियन सी. लो प्रेशर डेवलपिंग ओवर द मिडल ईस्टर्न कंट्रीज सेंट्रल एशियन कंट्रीज बिकॉज ऑफ विच विंड्स आर मूविंग फ्रॉम द हाई प्रेशर टुवर्ड्स लो प्रेशर. व्हेन दीस वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेज दीस विंड्स आर रीचिंग ओवर इंडिया इन सेंट्रल एशिया दे बाइफर्केट इनटू टू पार्ट्स. वन ब्रांच एंटर्स इन इंडिया इन अ प्लेन्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड अनदर ब्रांच एंटर्स इन चाइना. ठीक है ना. उससे टेम्परेचर में इंक्रीज आता है इन बोथ द पार्ट्स. क्लियर. हाई प्रेशर मेडिटेरेनियन सी में आता है. चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं. रबी विच जनरली इन विच एज द वीट मस्टर्ड दीज क्रॉप्स आर प्रोड्यूस इन अ पार्ट्स ऑफ पंजाब हरियाणा. वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस. ओके सो अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ अ प्रेसिपिटेशन ड्यूरिंग द विंटर्स अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ रेनफॉल ड्यूरिंग द विंटर्स under the sorry due to western disturbances, western disturbances helps in growth of rabi crops due to introduction of green revolution in which modern inputs of farming supported to increase in agricultural production in which of the states? Yes, you first girl, Divita. In which of the states which are mostly benefited under the green revolution? Okay, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana. Very good. Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, northwestern Uttar Pradesh, highly benefited under the green revolution, in which yielding varieties of seeds assured irrigation, use of machines in agriculture, insecticides, pesticides, fertilizers supported raise production from smaller agricultural fields. Full stop. Till there, any doubts? Yes, Rahul, chale aage. Yes, green revolution saath money ka haan aata hai. For this the government has doing the work, efforts, reforms we will discuss at a later. For example, Dhavnesh having as of 1 acre of a land, 1 acre, it will be as provide their sources of their property to the banks. They are giving as a certain amount of a money at their account. Whenever the Dhavnesh, it will use that amount of a money, then the bank will charge interest. Agar us Dhavnesh us money ko pura saal use nahi kara hai, bank it will not charge the interest. It will be the procured in their bank account. This scheme is known as a Kisan Credit Cards, KCC. ठीक है ना, ऐसी स्कीम्स लॉन्च की गई हैं, कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज हैं विच आर लेंडिंग मनी एट अ लो कॉस्ट, वी विल डिस्कस एट अ लेटर. ठीक है ना, वो अमाउंट क्या, इसको 80,000 रुपीज दे दिए, इसके पास 1 acre लैंड है, वो 80,000 रुपीज जब ये यूज करेगा उसमें, चाहे उसमें से 10,000 इसने विड्रॉ करवाया, 10,000 पे इंटरेस्ट लगेगा, पूरे पे नहीं लगेगा. बट एज कंपेयर टू दिस, व्हेन द धवनेश इट विल बोरो द लोन फ्रॉम अशीन, शी विल चार्ज अ कंप्लीट इंटरेस्ट रेट एज अ 10% 12% मंथली बेसिस. Money lenders, they try to exploit the farmers. Clear, Dhavnesh? Chalein aage. Zaid. Zaid is the short agricultural season extends in between of Rabi and Kharif. Kharif, Rabi mat keh dena. Rabi, Kharif. Winters aur summers ke beech mein aata hai. Rainy season mein. It generally extends in May and June, in which mostly such crops are produced by farmers which are ready to harvest in 45 to 60 days. Such crops like pulses, in pulses as arhar, jo sambar ki dal hoti hai, arhar, masoor, comma watermelon is time pe aata hai. वैसे वाटरमेलन तो थ्रू आउट द ईयर अवेलेबल है, तनेजा थ्रू आउट द ईयर, ऑफ सीजन भी अवेलेबल अभी भी है, और करेक्ट टाइम पीरियड एज द मे एंड जून. वाटरमेलन, कुकुम्बर एटसेट्रा इन नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया Bajra and barley used as a fodder crops. Used as a fodder crops, which earlier as a, at the time of independence, before the independence, these were the staple diet of humans. Bajra, maize. But presently, these are basically used for a fodder crops. Clear? These are the cropping patterns. All the cropping patterns. Till there in doubts, next are the major crops, yes? Haanji, nahi, export hote hain. ड्राई फ्रूट्स इंपोर्ट होते हैं आप ये कह रहे हैं एक्सपोर्ट हो हाँ जी होती है माउंटेन्स में होती है मोस्टली सीजन नॉट श्योर मैं बाद में बता दूंगा आप एनी अदर हाँ जी सीड्स हो रहे हैं सीड्स के पेड़ लगते हैं जैसे वॉलनट है इसका पेड़ होता है ट्री होता है बहुत बड़ा होता है जितने ये बाहर लगे हुए हैं वॉलनट एंड बेसिकली जो बैट्स बनते हैं For bats, it is as a preferable to use as a wood obtained from the walnut tree. Uski use ki jati hai. Aapko jyada pata hoga cricket. Any other? Baki kal. Anybody else? So any of the questions? Yes. Himanshu.